gotta turn off the kitchen light because I forgot my phone was on the plug.
Town's been dark a while now. Could be a mechanical trying to sabotage us.
Cysty pigs are gross. Cysty pigs are gross. Meow, after titties.
Thank you.
sleepy. Nah, he's sleepy. Just taking a nap.
I'd wager this is the outpost. Rebecca! Anders! Come on out! Returning fire!
Huh. Rebecca taught me this once. You can jerry-rig these old locks so as they don't open anymore. But we've only ever done that if we're in a real bind. Here, I'll fix it.
Gander. The door's busted. Oh no. Oh no. What did you do?
Oh hell. I'm sorry, Nyoka.
I don't... They were... The bitch! They were all sent to abandon us! What would Clara say, huh? Every day she'd ask if we heard from you. And she'd have forgiven you. The kid had a soul that made the sulfur smell like roses. Hard to leave your medallions to rot with you, but Clara would want to be buried with her sister.
At least I know. Ought to have learned by now that getting one's hopes up tends to open them to being dashed across the stars. I hate to say this, but Clara died thinking her sister was still fighting to get back home. I think I'm glad. If she were still alive now, it'd break her to know the truth.
That a lot.
Yeah, maybe. I'm used to disappointment. She was still so naive as to let it hurt her every time it happened. Only thing left is to take these medallions home, which means figuring out how to bait the Mana Queen out of our old base. The most pissed off I've ever seen a queen was when a foreign species was on her soil. I'd wager the stench of a primal might do the trick. That'd be boring. Half the fun in exploring is the fact that you're on an unknown trail. I've never had the pleasure of hunting primals, but I hear they're all over Scylla. Let's tear a few apart, shall we? I'm sure they've got pheromones. Everything does.
I don't know who you are or why you're prowling around here, but I'm willing to make a guess. You're one of Harlow's gun hands, ain't you? He sent you after me. Former wife. And if you so much as heard a hair on Rosanna's head, I will put you in the ground. Yeah, okay. I'm having a conversation with a hired killer, but I'm supposed to relax. Thing is, you and I are at an impasse. Harlow wants me dead, and I've got no intention of dying. How do I know that I can trust you? Yeah, guess that's a fair point. Listen, I don't know what lies Harlow's dripped down your ear, but you'd be a fool to trust him. I never betrayed Harlow. Harlow betrayed all of us. The board's got him in their pocket, been paying him off for years. All that palaver about revolutions, it's a lie.
You can't be serious. I've known the guy for years.
Yeah, that's about how I reacted when I found out. That's the whole truth. Harlow's just another board asset. A two-bit mercenary wearing a dissident's clothes. Say your piece. Because he's for sale. Anything the board can buy, the board will buy, and that includes loyalty. Harlow was a charismatic bastard, and he was ruthless. With Harlow in their pocket, the board had an informant, a pirate, a smuggler, and a gang leader all rolled up into one odious excuse for a human being. Sounds like a deal to me. Board sanctioned piracy. Harlow went after the ships the board wanted destroyed, capturing anybody the board wanted captured. If we captured you, we'd ransom you. Harlow liked to do the job himself. Gather up the captives on his own ship, vanish for a couple of days. Only that's not what happened. Harlow's been selling his captives off to the board. I don't know where they ended up. Re-education, Tartarus, maybe worse. Yeah, I've got proof. There's always a paper trail when the board's involved. I chanced upon some correspondence between Harlow and his employer. I don't know that it makes a difference. What was I to do with that evidence? Bring it in front of the board? There's no authority in Halcyon willing to take Harlow to task. You ain't like other board agents I heard about. You got a functioning spine. You want to confront Harlow yourself? Be my guest. I hid my papers before Harlow chased me out. Back in the middle of the base, there's an old vent in a utility corridor. I stashed my evidence in that vent. Take it you've made up your mind. You gonna tell Harlow I'm dead? May as well. I'm never going back to that life again. Here, take the ring. And for what it's worth, my gratitude.
Clyde Harlow, agent of the board. Yeah, that sounds even more insane out loud than it did in my head. I'm not sure what to think right now. You told me to be suspicious, but I never imagined Clyde would stoop to informing for the establishment. Then again, Trask knew he was a dead man. Could have been trying to shift the blame. I can't imagine Clyde working for the board. But we owe it to ourselves to find out. Trask said he stashed the evidence in a vent back at the base. We should go take a look.
Destination reached. Scylla.
That queen ain't gonna go down easy. I can't wait. What's up? Outstanding. These ought to be enough. Let's get back to Monarch. There's an old base I used to call home. I can get us in the door, but we'll have to shoot our way through the Queen's brood to get to the center. We'll set the bait there. Password to the door is Charon. Hayes' idea. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, Nioka. Charon. He said it was some old myth. Something about death and all the things we killed. Rest of us just thought it sounded cool, so here we are. It's an old cave system we tried to turn into an encampment. You'll see when we get there. Fucking right we are.
There's a proper encampment.
Clyde must be inside.
Thank you.
need to have a word with Clyde. Looks like Trask was telling the truth. It's all there. Receipts for services rendered, payments, records, ship manifests. Clyde was a pirate for hire, and the board was paying him off. In typical board fashion, they left a trail of receipts behind. Ain't that just ironic? Yeah, you and me both. Clyde owes us, some answers. Something about this don't add up. And I mean to find out why.
What's the word? Not surprised. Trask was a dead man trying to negotiate with his own executioner. He'd say anything to preserve his life. That's a damning accusation. Am I right to presume you have some evidence on hand? Those papers don't prove a thing. We've all done business with the board. They own the whole damn colony. Trask put you up to this. That miserable wretch. He's trying to undermine everything I stand for. You've got a lot of nerve calling me a liar to my face. How should I know? What the hell do I care? Trask was a traitor. I didn't ask you to understand his motives. I asked you to cross him off.
Clyde, look me in the eye and tell me it's not true. Tell me, and I'll believe you.
Don't talk to me like I'm some common criminal, Felix. You're the one on trial, not me. I don't know what kind of poison that snake dripped in your ear, but as far as I'm concerned, you've been compromised.
Jackass, is he coming? Nobody messes with you, boss. Still got it.
I heard him.
Felix!
Looks like we're doing this.
Yeah.
up, boss! Everyone all right? Getting started.
this one have a thing next to it?
Thank you. As always, I am at your disposal. Anything you'd like to discuss?
This is definitely not how I imagined it'd end. The void's black, water's wet, and Clyde hated the board. That's something I just knew. Now? I don't know. I don't know what to think. No. I guess you really don't. I've just got a lot on my mind right now. This is a lot to take in. I always looked up to Clyde. The thought that he could be an agent of the board is just abhorrent to me.
Which one of these two to go with? Bottom one or the middle one? Huh?
Yeah, he did. And I'm not sure how I'm gonna get over that. I hope so. I don't see this one passing anytime soon. You've given me a lot to think about. I'm gonna be mulling over this whole mess for a couple of days. Part of me wishes we'd put Trask in the ground. You know, I think that's just my frustration talking. Thanks for your time, boss.
Thank you.
attack, lockpick, persuade. One of these three. Huh? All 10? Should I up science weapon damage? Or should I do armor? Science weapon or armor? Do this one? Because I don't exactly put any points in defense.
Hey, Cap.
Good to see you, boss.
I could probably spend years fixing this boat, stem to stern. Oh, you mean Sam? He's just the sweetest, ain't he? A real charmer, my dad'd say. Nah, but I've been thinking on one. Gotta get to know him better, I think. Maybe ask him what he prefers. It ain't nice to give folks a nickname without them giving you the okay first, you know? Of course, that don't stop Felix.
So then I told him, oh, ha ha ha, that tickles. How odd. No, don't desist. I think I might like it. Further data collection is required for accurate assessment.
The ship has a thing for the robot. The ship has a thing for this robot.
Issuing sanitation ticket.
Welcome back, Captain. May luck. We're in orbit over Cascadia, Captain.
Whew. Here we go. I haven't set foot in here since. Well, I'm ready. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Here we go. Okay. Hell of a job. Real slick.
Well, this is the spot. You know, I thought I'd be angry. I thought I'd storm in here in a rage and exterminate all these bugs and everything would be all right in the end. But I ain't. I'm mostly just empty. A little sad, maybe. The first night Hayes and I spent in here, we knew it was home. It's safe. It's got a nice chill to it. But mostly, it doesn't stink of sulfur. Monarch folks often joke about it. Not because of the smell or the grittiness it leaves in your throat. Not because of the headaches or the coughing. It's because there's no escaping it. It's life here, and there ain't anything you can do about it. But here, somehow the sulfur never made it. The nights we spent in here felt like vacations. So we started building. We hauled in steel, hired sublight folk to help. That's how we met Anders and Opal. They stuck around after our contract was up. Opal liked camping. Anders liked chasing her tail. Four of us for a while, scraping together what bits we could to build our home. Then came Rebecca, a sawbones out of the Cascadia survivors, who took a kindness to Hayes. And Clara, her little sister. I'll admit I wasn't keen on taking her on at first. But for a teenager, she was surprisingly capable. More like attached at the hip to her older sister. Got a kind of strength between them, I suppose. She had a head for numbers, helped us trade hides for food and materials, negotiated contracts. Turned out to be mighty useful. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, and me. Six folks, one name, one family, Charon. Despite Monarch trying to kill us day in and day out, we managed to belong.
Here they come.
I wish these were more auspicious circumstances, but at least we're all here. This bringing them together, burying them. This is the kind of thing Hayes would have done. That makes it stupid. By all accounts, we should have left well enough alone, but that also makes it right. Captain, thank you. You mind if we rest a spell before we head out? I'd like to bury Opal and Clara proper before I lay everyone's medallions to rest. You know, I'd been assuming this entire stay-on-your-ship thing isn't a permanent arrangement. Part of my contract? That said, you ain't been eaten or shot to death yet. Says a lot about the stability of your future. And to be honest, I'm about sick of sleeping on bar stools. So how's about this? You keep letting me stay on that ship of yours, and I'll keep shooting at the things you point at. Outstanding.
Level up like every 2 fucking seconds.
Thank you.
to Byzantium yet.
We have successfully arrived at Phineas's orbital lab, Captain, and we are still in one piece. Shall I congratulate myself, or would you like to do the honors? Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? I'll be here. Welcome back. How can I... Take care. Stay safe out there.
Hello? Can you hear me? Does this work? Oh, damn it! Blast, that's loud! I'm just securing my ongoing experiments. And securing myself. Mind the mess. I haven't had a visitor since... In fact, I've never had a visitor.
Thank you. my communications terminal. Try it on a marauder sometime.